Hey heroes, Cap here, and welcome back to the channel. Today we'll be taking a look at Marvel's Avengers and the gear reworks that are coming our way with patch 2.2 at the end of this month. That goes from changing the resources, changing how to upgrade, changing what we can expect with the gear, as well as a power level increase. If you go on to like the content, be sure to smash that thumbs up as it greatly helps me and gets the video out to more people to inform them on the amazing gear reworks that are coming our way. Without further ado, let's jump in and check out the gear reworks of Marvel's Avengers coming at the end of this month. Crystal Dynamics, the developers behind Marvel's Avengers, released a dev stream kind of giving us a detail of all the gear reworks that are coming our way. So let's dive in and check it out. Starting with, first, all perks on gear are going to be unlocked, which is amazing because it's no longer, oh, I need to upgrade this for science. It's like, I upgrade this just to unlock the perks to see how great they actually work. And then the next greatest thing that I'm super excited about is all statuses, all heroes. That means Hulk's gonna be rocking some cryo. We've got Iron Man with some shock lasers gonna be attached. I'm particularly excited to get some shock damage on my Cap build to kind of do like Cap, if he could have like Mjolnir, just unleash a whole bunch of shock damage. So stay tuned for that. I really am excited for that part of it. Another thing that's coming with this patch is the fact that resources are gonna be changed around quite a bit. So, as you see on this screen here, I've got my Black Widow pulled up for us to take a look at. And now the resources up here in the top is what we want to be looking at. Now, first of all, these in the middle are going to be gone away. That's the nanites, the nanotubes, the catalysts, the plasma, as well as the Uru over here will all be taken out of the game. They're going to be converted into fragments, upgrade modules, and polychoron, which is what we will use when we want to upgrade our gear using that method. We can still dismantle gear just like normal, and in the rare occasion that you do dismantle gear, you might get some polychoron out of it, which is amazing because it's one of the hardest resources to gather, except for from, of course, your daily missions and villain sectors that you complete. Now, we know these resources are throughout all the missions, and even some of the enemies drop them. So they will be changed, and the levels will change as well with the fragments and upgrade modules coming from enemies and resource bins. Now, the higher the difficulty, the more resources you get. But some of these low level won't drop anything at all just because it's such a low level. It's like the little drones that fly around that are all one shot. Super easy, obviously not gonna drop, but the adaptoid that you face will probably drop a little bit more than you expect. Now, taking a look at how we're gonna be upgrading gear going forward. Now, at first you have this one, you can see the unlock perk button. So if you hold it, it unlocks the perk. We won't have to worry about that anymore as all perks will be unlocked, which means you don't have to worry about leveling things up to test them to see how they do. You will know right away. Equip the gear, you get all two perks that you have on it, and you're good to go, which is amazing. I love it. It's definitely a nice quality of life kind of update to the game and the gear itself. Now, if you want to upgrade gear, it doesn't start until you hit power level 100 on your gear. Now, this is to help people from wasting resources as they're going, because essentially as you, if you're still leveling up and trying to get that 150 power level, you just usually hold the Q if you're on keyboard, or I think it's right trigger or left trigger on Xbox, and you just hold that to equip the best. That way you don't waste resources on upgrading when you're just going to get better and better gear as you play the game. So with this new patch 2.2 that's coming on November 30th, the way to upgrade will be very different, with the fact that if I have 140 gear, but this 130, like power level 130 gear is super good and that's what I want, I can actually infuse the 140 into the 130 and it bumps it up to that 140 power level, which takes away the having to hold a button and wait for it to level up 10 times. Now, it will still take resources. It'll take the resources all at once, and those will change based on what you're absorbing. So if you're going from like epic to epic, it'll be a normal exchange rate, same for legendary to legendary. But if you're going from epic to legendary, it will be at a higher rate than if you were going to legendary down to epic, because obviously the rarity of the item itself. There will be a new prompt to upgrade as well, which I will show on the screen, and you can see that now you can infuse the gear and show off how to get a higher level gear by using the old gear that you would normally just dismantle, throw away, or send to your locker and forget about until one day you try to clean your locker and realize that there's 500 pieces in there and you're like, why did I do this to myself? So for example, if you had power level 100 gear and you're going to infuse it with 101 gear to get it up to that next level, it will take 100 fragments, 10 upgrade modules. This is a base rate. It seems to be kind of along those lines based on the rarity, power level, and what perks and roles you are getting with the new gear. Now, as you upgrade, of course, the roles will change, the numbers will go higher, and you'll get better stats from them. Now, the big question is, what about all this old gear that I have? Like, what will happen to it? No need to fear. If you have 130 gear and that you need to test the perks for science, congratulations. On November 30th, you will get all those perks unlocked as well. It's not just new gear going forward, it's all gear retrospective. So any gear that you have with you when you log in will have the perks unlocked, ready to go, and you can start infusing and upgrading to get you to that 140 power level on your gear. That's all about the gear. Let's talk about the power level cap increase. Now, this was on the roadmap that they showed us, and it's one of the things that we're super excited for. I can't wait to try to get it to that 175 power level. However, I will say they made it a definite grind and challenge. So let's check it out. Starting off, 140 is still your max that you can level up gear to. Now, you're saying, but power level 175, my gear is 140, how do I get there? Let me tell you. They wanted to make sure that you have a reason to play the raid and the OLT besides just getting slightly better gear than what we already had, because they're definitely a grind. Now with the OLT and the regular raid, the Claw Discordant raid, we will get gear that gets us up to that 150 power level on the gear and will continue to give us better and better gear up to a certain max. Now if we want that 165 power level gear and to get us to that 175 power level cap, we'll have to play the Elite Discordant Sound raid, which is what will get us that 165 power level gear. And like I said, if you get 165 power level gear, but it doesn't have the roles or the perks that you want that your 150 gear, don't worry, you can infuse it to get that 165 power level on that lower gear. This is amazing because if you get higher level gear, but it's just not beating what you already have, you can infuse it simply and get that power level that you're actually looking for. I think this is a great addition. It's fantastic because it was terrible when you would get like higher power level gear, but it doesn't beat the perks and the rolls that you have on your lower level, and you can only max it out to a certain level. Now infusing it, I could literally take, if I found a power level 100 gear piece that was just somehow amazing with amazing rolls and key perks and everything, I could just infuse it all the way up to that 165 power level max now that we have. So you can still upgrade to 140, but in order to get any higher, you'll have to complete the OLT, the regular Discordant Sound Raid, as well as the Elite Discordant Sound Raid to get you to that 165 and infuse gear to get you there. Or use the gear that it drops, because hopefully it'll drop some amazing, amazing gear. And there we have it, all the gear reworks that we have to look forward to in patch 2.2 on November 30th when it drops for Marvel's Avengers. I'm super excited for it. It all looks good. The all statuses for all heroes and the perks upgrade I super like. And then the ability to infuse gear and pull that power level to the gear that I already have is fantastic, because I kind of like the gear that I have and I don't really know how they could get better. However, I keep getting proved wrong and wrong as I find more and more gear and kind of switch things around to get different builds. So once again, if you enjoyed what you liked, make sure to smash that thumbs up and hit the subscribe for more content coming your way, as well as let me know in the comments if you have any questions below, because I do understand that's a lot of information and it was a bit overwhelming the first time hearing it, and I had to like go back and like read it, focus on it, and like, oh, okay, that's what you mean, that's what you mean. But let me know in the comments, I will do my best to answer the questions or make another video if the same question gets popped up a whole bunch. I do stream live over on Twitch 4 days a week, so come on over, let's chat Marvel, Marvel Gaming, Marvel's Avengers, whatever nerdiness you have, and I will play in this game live, of course. As always, heroes, stay amazing, and until the next video, bye-bye.